If you could be born again, what color would you be born?
All white.
Why? Why?
White is beautiful. White is pure.
So black ain't beautiful?
Black is beautiful, so black ain't beautiful. If you make it. But the way it is now, are turning their color horrible. Making a bad look for their family.
Everybody, I am D Mamazelle and this is my channel, and today we are going to be doing a reaction to a lady who's black but she doesn't want to be black anymore. Before anyone comments down below and they're like, oh my god, this stuff is fake, oh my god, it's staged, this is for entertainment purposes only, fake or not, that's a crazy ass storyline, and I'm sure there's a lot of people who feel the same way this lady feels. Now my watch is probably going to be going off this entire freaking time. I don't know, I put my phone on do not disturb, so I don't know why I'm still getting notifications on my watch, but sorry about that if it happens to happen. Okay, before we get into this video, make sure you smash that subscribe button, smash that like button, smash every other button, you know that will help me. Follow me on social media, get your merchandise, and if you have any video suggestions for me, there is a link down below where I actually check that more than my DMs. Please stop sending suggestions to my DM. My DM is like flooded, like y'all, like I don't think y'all understand. Everything you need is going to be down in the description box below. So let's get straight into this video. Hey, remember like, no. Yeah, I'm sorry. I haven't done a reaction in so long. Like, let's just move over, man. I haven't done one of these in a while. Jesus Christ, man. I just had to get my other videos out there, you feel me? I had to get all the, like, suggested videos out. Even though I know that those videos wouldn't get as many views as I should be getting, like, I had to get all of those out first. But let's get straight into it. So this video is going to probably have to be in two parts because it's a 34-minute video. That's a long-ass video. So.
Now, Desmond and his wife, Tanisha, are married 3 years. They have three beautiful children.
Aww.
The problem, well, Desmond says Tanisha is obsessed with being white.
Yo, she got the blonde wig and everything. Look at her. She look a whole hot ass mess. Oh, this is going to be fun. I'm going to have a field day. I'm going to have a field day with this lady, yeah?
In fact, Tanisha moved her family from Chicago to rural Iowa to get away from her black neighborhood. Now, she even wears a blonde wig and blue contacts to blend in around town. But
blend in where? Blend in where? Where are you going? What you think this? Fifth. What are you doing? Blending where? Oh my god. Somebody needs to give these motherfuckers some medicine. Oh my god.
Worst of all, Desmond suspects his wife is secretly having an affair with a white sugar daddy.
Sorry.
Here's a glimpse into the mindset of Tanisha.
Almost 3 years ago, I decided to move from Chicago to Iowa to escape the black community. I decided the lifestyle of the white community in Iowa was the way I wanted to live. I don't care for the black race. I think the white race is more educated, civilized, and sophisticated.
None of that has to do with race, but okay, sis.
I'm embarrassed to be black. I want the white race to embrace me and treat me as if I was white. Because I think and I act white. My family...
While I do that dramatic pause, comment down below what you think about that comment. Okay.
Thinks that I should be ashamed of myself because I think and I act white, but I'm not going to be who they want me to be. Because when I'm with them, I have to act ghetto, and I hate it. My husband and my cousins think that I have a white sugar daddy, but I don't. He's just a good friend that takes care of me. I think white men are better providers. And if I was with one, I would have a different life.
Wait. How you hate black people and you got a white man who take care of you, but you ended up marrying a black man? I really would love to know how that happened. And I really hope she asks her this question, because I'm very curious. I'm very curious right now.
Wow. Desmond, does Tanisha talk like that at home or act like that?
Yeah, she does. She done lost her mind. She thinks she
not a
Dubai.
She done lost her mind.
New contact.
What do you think of that?
She done lost her damn mind.
So, how come you moved from Chicago to Iowa then?
She want to be around white folks. I don't know. I don't understand why we from Chicago to middle of the city, you know, nothing but ghetto, nothing but black folks. And there's nothing wrong. I have nothing, no problem with white folks.
Now, Chicago has the third largest black population in the nation, while the remote Iowa town that Tanisha and Desmond now call home has approximately 200 black people total.
If.
So what is this with this white sugar daddy?
Listen, I don't have a problem with white people, but I would not feel comfortable being around predominantly white people. Well, I'm black, and I don't think I would be comfortable around so many white people. Like, I don't know, but then again, that's me about everything. I don't feel comfortable around a predominant group of anything. I feel like I need to be in a mixed environment. Like, it has to be mixed. It has to be like a melting pot. If it's not a melting pot, I'm not gonna feel comfortable. So I don't know how she doing it, especially those type of towns, those them Trump areas. I don't know. She bugging.
What's going on?
I don't know. She claimed me just a friend, but I'm not 100% for sure what's going on.
Is she getting money from him?
Yeah, she getting money from him.
How much?
I didn't give it to her.
How much?
I couldn't tell you how much it is.
She said she believes her life would be different, I'm guessing better, if she was married to a white man. Is that a concern for you being...
I think she need to go find one then.
Since you about to be husbandless, you better go find that white man now. He is not having it today. He is not having it with his wife shenanigans.
It's been painful. You're working hard.
Yes.
Yeah, that is painful.
Our kids and her. Very much.
Does she go out? She does.
And I don't have no problem with her going out. It's just that, you know, you can't be... The people that she kicks with is only white folks. If we happen to get together at the house, her friends come in, and then she makes sure they're gone before the family comes.
What?
Yeah, that's crazy.
So she has two sittings, one for the white folks, one for the colored folks.
Yeah, isn't that crazy?
We're going to meet her, and I know some parts of your family, like her cousins, don't agree with how she's feeling.
Nah, nobody. She's the same way. She crazy. She lost her damn mind.
I think now we should actually meet Tanisha, don't you?
Yes.
Find out why she feels like this. Let's welcome Tanisha. Come on out.
The thing is, she's a very pretty lady. Like, she's a really pretty lady. That's why I'm just like, nah, this has to be staged, because she doing a little bit too much for me. Like, oh my god, like, what do you... Sis, like, I don't believe this shit.
Malibu Barbie here.
So, Tanisha.
Yes.
If you could be born again, what color would you be born?
All white.
Why? Why?
White is beautiful. White is pure.
So black ain't beautiful?
Black is beautiful, black ain't beautiful. If you make it. But the way it is now, are turning their color horrible. Making a bad look for their self.
That's it.
Okay, you know what? She right to an extent, but black is still beautiful, and there's a lot of black people who are doing a lot of positive things in the community, so I don't think she should be saying that. Maybe she's been around the wrong type of black people, like...
What are your beliefs about black people, the black people that you've come across so far back in Chicago for
us? I mean, where I come from, blacks are killing each other. I live in Chi-Rock. It is horrible there. I cannot raise my three daughters, our daughters, in a place where I don't feel comfortable, safe. And I don't feel like that's a place where I would want to raise my kids, our kids.
Fair enough.
I get that, but that's fair. What the whole thing
happened? Oh my God, this is
fine. Would you call yourself racist against black people?
Yes.
No.
Yes.
Yes?
Just think about it.
Yes. Then don't start that black people can't be racist. Stop, don't do it. What is this called? Well, self-hatred. This is definitely self-hatred. This is beyond self-hatred. This is a problem.
You can have anything around blacks. If they see you with it, they want it.
Do you think you're like to be better if you were married to a white guy?
Nigga, Blue's Clues? Fuck you talking, what? Kisa? Hey! Kiski, what passes to you is on Belty Tabak. Basketball lit fell with him. I want to slap her. Who's going to slap her first? We could all get in line just to slap her. Excuse me? I don't want nothing that nobody else got. I don't know what she's talking about. No, see, this is where I draw the line.
I mean, my life would be different.
In what way?
We probably would have had a better house. We probably would have had a better car right now. Yes, his credit score probably would be super high right now. Yes, indeed.
Credit scores. You are literally crazy.
Okay, I am crazy. You can call me whatever, but to be honest with you, I'm being who I think.
Do you feel uncomfortable with our audience? We have so many black people in the audience. Is that why?
Yes.
No, because there's security here.
Somebody to run up, like, come on, bro. Audience, like, come on, run up. Whoa, I'm tired of being on my bullets. I'm so bad. Oh my gosh, she's too funny. Oh man.
Wow. Are you serious?
She's embarrassing.
Security.
Settle down, ghetto rats.
This is too much.
She said it right. I'm glad you think it's funny.
Are you worried about me? Are you worried I might come over and bug you or something? Or am I okay?
The way she acts, you would think so.
No, but I'm interested in it.
I don't feel any intimidation towards you.
Why am I different?
Just the way you talk.
The English accent.
Yes.
Oh,
wow.
Is that what you see as a white accent?
Yes. It sounds very good. I feel safe around you.
You hear this? She feels safe.
Wow.
But don't even know you.
Yo, I can't.
Sugar daddy of yours.
I don't have a sugar
daddy. Well, I don't know. He gives you money for what? I clean up this man's house. He's an older man.
Okay.
And I go and I clean up. Okay.
But you cleaning his bedroom?
Right? No, I'm not.
Ooh!
Can I ask you if he?
I'm not even gonna answer that. That is just
how
my
much money? Silly. How much money?
Ain't nobody gonna be giving you money.
He gives me a lot of money,
yo.
But that's the most silliest thing you ever could have said. I don't have to ask him for anything. First of all, a man knows when you need something and you don't have to ask for it. So I did never.
Okay, she's speaking some sense. This is why I don't ever let a man buy me weed. First of all, I get sponsors. I don't ever have to buy hair ever again. Second of all, I hate when men do that. Don't be throwing that back in my face, okay? You bought me this wig. This is my wig. Get out of here. Like, but that was really funny.
On my husband, okay?
You love him.
I love him.
The one thing I haven't asked is why do you wear that blonde wig?
I mean,
she cries.
Just think about it.
Okay.
There's no black girl in this audience have never, when they was a child, ever not wanted to have long, pretty blonde hair. You can lie and say that all you want, but the first dog on down your mother bought you was a white dog. You comb that hair every single dog on deck, and you wish your hair was that long and pretty. So now I'm able to wear it.
You know what? I can't lie. I did, when I was really young, wanted long hair. I don't know if I wanted blonde hair, but I do really like blonde people. I think blonde, like girls with blonde hair are really, really pretty, but I also think black girls with black hair are really, really pretty. So I don't think it's that serious. I don't, but I do see she's coming from, because I actually had friends who were black and they really, really, really wanted long blonde hair too. So, okay, she kind of, she's just the wrong person to be sending the message, but I get the message.
And I'm gonna blunt. All right.
Yes,
the cousins say is that you kind of, are you embarrassed about your cousins?
Yeah.
Yes.
Why?
They are ghetto.
What happens when they come to your parties that you have with all the folk? Do they mix with that?
No, I did that before and it didn't turn out right.
What?
So now you live and you learn.
She shoots them out that, I told you, the white folks party first.
You live
and then the rest of the
family. Exactly.
Well, what's wrong with your cousins being there? How do they act?
They want to take food home. People can't come and eat. So as soon as they get there, black folks always.
Hang on, let's hear this. Hang on.
Every time they come over, they got to take a plate home for their cousin, their auntie. They don't even live with none of them. They got to take things home every time they come to my house. And then when my guests come, there's nothing to eat.
Yo, she not lying about that though. She's not lying, especially Haitians. Haitians take a whole plato, bro. They take a whole trail. So I'm not even gonna dispute that she right. But that doesn't mean that white people don't do it too. I've seen plenty of white people do it, okay? My best friend is white. Jessica, if you're watching this, shout outs to you. She does that. Okay, she is Polish and Ukrainian. She does that all the time. So I don't understand why that's only characteristic to black people, but I mean, I've seen all types of people do it. Hispanic, black, white. I've seen all types of people take food home and not leave shit for anybody else. I've seen it, so.
Don't take no food out of my house.
Do they drink?
Yeah, they pick you up on that house in the home. Do you understand me? And not put on
that's
anything.
That's all party.
Do they make you embarrassed?
Of course. Every time we go to any club or anything, they got a problem. Want to dance all nasty, y'all on the floor popping. Who does that?
It's called having fun.
Classiness. They're not class enough. All right, well, as you know, Cousin Sherry and Koshana are here to set Tanisha straight.
Okay. I'm here for it. I'm ready.
The other thing that Tanisha is here to do, she's done a lie detector test. Because what did you want to find out?
What's really going on with this sugar daddy?
Okay.
Oh, I can't wait for this.
Okay. We'll reveal the results of the lie detector too, so stay with us.
Video's getting too long, but stay tuned for part two, okay? Coming real, real soon to a computer near you. This is interesting. I can't wait to see the lie detector test, and I can't wait to see what happens after all of this is unfolded, because this lady is crazy, is all hell. She need to get her life together, okay? She got problems. She got real serious problems. But let me know what you think about this video down in the comment section below. Do you think that she's justified in the way that she's thinking? Do you think that she's full out, flat out wrong? Do you think that she's just basing her opinions based on black stereotypes? Do you think she's racist? Do you think she's not racist? Let me know down in the comment section below. Thumbs up this video, okay? Smash that like button if you really want to see part two, but I'm going to do it anyway. Make sure you follow me on social media. Like, share, subscribe, do all that. And I'ma see y'all next time.